Hi everybody, today is May 10th, 2013. I'm afraid to tell you, but the poo's about to hit the fan. Donald Trump, billionaire, tells America to prepare for financial ruin. The United States could soon become a large-scale Spain or Greece, teetering on the edge of financial ruin, and I expected this to happen. Mostly because of this article here, if you read between the lines, the House passed a bill to prioritize U.S. debt payments. The GOP-controlled House voted Thursday to make sure U.S. bondholders and people on Social Security get paid if the government hits its borrowing limit. They're preparing for, you know, the crash and who they will pay. And, of course, it's going to be the foreign people that have loaned us money. And then, supposedly, Social Security. But there probably won't be Social Security. There'll be no food stamps. There'll be no welfare. They're expecting a downgrade in our credit rating. It says here the idea behind Thursday's legislation passed on a near party line, 221 to 207 vote, is to lessen the consequences of a U.S. default on its debt obligations if Congress and President Barack Obama can't find a way to lift the government's borrowing limit later this year. According to Donald Trump, who painted a very ugly picture of where this country is headed, Trump made the comments during a recent appearance on Fox News on the record with Greta Van Susteren. According to Trump, the United States is no longer a rich country. When you're not rich, you have to go out and borrow money. We're borrowing from the Chinese and others. We're up to $16 trillion in debt, and it's actually a lot more than that. I heard somewhere around $21 trillion in debt. He goes on to point out that the downgrade of U.S. debt is inevitable. We are going up to $16 trillion in debt very soon, and it's going to be a lot higher than that before he gets finished. When you have a debt in the $21 to $22 trillion mark, you are talking about a downgrade no matter how you cut it. Ballooning debt and credit downgrade aren't Trump's only worries for this country. He says that the official unemployment rate of 8.2% isn't the real number, and I've showed you guys how they've, you know, fiddle with the numbers and it doesn't count people who are now claiming disability, who are on Social Security, people who just stop looking. People who can't find work after a certain length of time are taken out of the numbers too. He goes on to say that the real figure is closer to 15 to 16%. He even mentioned that some believe that unemployment rate to be as high as 21%. Right now, frankly, the country isn't doing well, Trump added. Recession may be a nice word. While 15 to 16% unemployment, a looming credit downgrade, and ballooning debt are a bleak outlook for the United States, they are hardly as alarming as the scenario laid out by another economics. Robert Redmer, he's very famous because he accurately predicted the economic collapse that almost sank the United States. In 2006, Redmer and a team of economics foresaw the coming collapse of the U.S. housing market, equity markets, private debt, and consumer spending, and published their findings in a book called America's Bubble Economy. But Wiedemer's outlook for the U.S. economy today makes Trump's observation seem almost optimistic, where Trump sees ballooning debt and a credit downgrade. Wiedemer sees much more widespread economic destruction. In a recent interview for his newest book, Aftershock, Wiedemer says the data is clear. 50% unemployment and a 90% stock market drop and 100% annual inflation starting in 2012. When the host questioned such wild claims, Wiedemer unapologetically displayed shock charts backing up his allegations and then ended his arguments with, "You see, the medicine will become the poison." The interview has become a wake-up call for those unprepared or unwilling to acknowledge the ugly truth. The country's financial rescue devised in Washington has failed miserably. The blame lies squarely on those whose job it is to avoid the exact situation we find ourselves in, including current Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke and former Chairman Alan Greenspan, tasked with preventing financial meltdowns and keeping the nation's economy strong through monetary and credit policies. At one point, Wiedemer even calls out Bernanke, saying that his money from heaven will be the path to hell. But it's not just the grim predictions that are causing the sensation. Rather, it's the comprehensive blueprint for economic survival that's really commanding global attention. The interview offers realistic step-by-step solution that the average hardworking American can easily follow. the overwhelmingly amount of feedback to publicists the interview initially screened for a private audience came with consequences as various online networks repeatedly shut it down and affiliates refused to house the content. Bernanke and Greenspan were not about to support Wiedemeyer publicly, nor were the mainstream media. People were sitting up and taking notice, and they begged us to make the interview public so they could easily share it, said Newsmax financial publisher Aaron DeHoogh. But unfortunately, it kept getting pulled. Our real concern, DeHoogh added, is what if only half of Wiedemeyer's predictions come true? That's a scary thought for sure, but we want the average American to be prepared. And that's why we will continue to push this video to as many outlets as we can. We want the word to spread. So anyways, if you put the two and two together about the debt payment, who they're going to prioritize to pay and who's not going to get paid, and many other people, not just Donald Trump saying that we're heading for a financial ruin, but if you have your eyes open, I think you can read the writing on the wall. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.